Yeah, Mike. I was giving you a call, man. I'm having an issue with this Nepo 4-box. And when I called Laura, she said it looks like I'm not connected to the internet. But it's weird because I know I've got a pretty good signal here using this Verizon router. So I wanted to see if maybe you could think of anything that might be able to troubleshoot it. Yeah, it has. This is a pretty regular location. Yep, it's about 1028. Got you.
He quickly corrects that one. He skies up the slam, that one making it 20-18 in favor of Belief Pro. Spinning inside, a little bit of contact. They let it go. They've been letting him play here early on. Nice pass ahead, and it's going to be an and-one scored. That's De La Rosa. Elvis De La Rosa. De La Rosa out of the Dominican Republic. Hey, hey. score now 30-23 in favor of Evelyn Mack, their home on the scoreboard. Way too easy on that score for Deshane M. And the names that I'm giving you here are basically the names I was given there in the scorebook roster. That'll be a backcourt violation. Subbing back in for Evelyn Mack will be number 15, Fode Kamara. Kamara with interest from North Carolina A&T. Trying to get his three-pointer going. He's off the mark. Whalen with the rebound. Takes a couple pokes in the face, but still the wherewithal to drop the dime for the Kwame Nelson lay-in. That'll make it 25-32 in favor of Evelyn Mack Academy. Shane brings it across. Guarded by Paris. Now he'll get it over to number one. That's TJ Killings. Killings called for the offensive foul. Stepping in and taking the charge there is Nelson. Bucket on one end. Stepping up, taking the charge on the other. Paris gets the pass ahead. Nice ball movement. Ball barely touches the floor before Whalen dunks it home, making it 25-34. You take a look there at that last play. You can see that's, you know, Paris, a good job not trying to force it ahead to Whalen. Makes the pass that leads to a pass. Whalen dunks it home from there. At last, Deuce made it. A 9-point advantage for Evelyn Mack as we approach the 3-minute mark. 3 minutes, 25 seconds remaining here on the first half clock. Now Whalen gonna try a 3-pointer. That one kicks off the back of the rim. Long rebound brought down by Killings. Killings goes behind the back, stops on a dime, and knocks down the mid-range J. That's a big-time move right there. Running full speed. Goes behind the back, elevates. Knocks down the mid-range J. That'll make it a 7-point game. Kwame Nelson, he's done a good job of finishing when they put him in a position to do so. Runs the floor this time, lays it in. Back to a 9-point advantage. Ashton Spears with the ball now. Get it over to Killings. Killings gets the step and the lay-in. TJ Killings, explosive. Killings going to be called for a foul there. See him, he has that potential to elevate and finish above the rim as we've seen this time. Just chooses to get the nice little lay-in. Kwame Nelson subs out for Evelyn Mack. Paris trying to get out of trouble. Did he get a timeout in time? Looks like he did. So Coach Primus and Evelyn Mack will talk it over. They have a 7-point advantage. You see that behind the back. Stop, elevate, and then that was a good contest by Whalen. Well, by that time, TJ Killings was just locked in. 29-36. We'll be back shortly. Back out of the timeout. Approaching the final 2 minutes here in the first half. It's a 7-point game. Active hands there, trying to save it, but right to Evelyn Mack Academy. That was number 5, DeShane, there with the hustle. Unable to keep Evelyn Mack off the offensive glass, but that one won't stay down there for number 13, Moise Cora. Here's a 3 from the corner. No good. Offensive rebound snatched out of there by Derek Green. That one's off the front of the rim, brought down by Paris. Paris has the cookies taken. Easy layup on the other end for Believe Prep. You don't see that happen too often. Good hands, good quick hands here by Believe Prep. Now Paris will take the mid-range. Can't get the bounce on that one. Playing volleyball inside is Whalen, trying to keep it alive until they can score it. Reinforcements, Akeem White, the NYC native, makes it a 7-point lead. Approaching the final minute of the first half, a little bit of razzle-dazzle. Now they'll kick it out to the wing. That was William S., number 35, a traveling violation called on Ashton Spears. Keem White throws it in. Whalen fakes the pass. A little bit of an awkward shot there. Kind of got duped into one I don't think he really wanted to take necessarily. But already committed, so just tried to make the best out of it. Here's Green. He'll pull it off. We'll see if Believe Prep holds for the last shot here. Or if they just take the first good one that comes available. Guess that question is answered. Get in the step. There is DeShane M. He's fouled and will go to the line. As you hear some of the insight being given from the Evelyn Mack Academy bench talking about DeShane, he has a penchant for attacking the basket. The Evelyn Mack bench imploring that the players make him show what he can do with the jump shot. Instead of playing him so tight, and giving them that step. Splits the pair of free throws. 6-point game in the process. Final 30 seconds. They've done a good job of trying to make Damari Paris uncomfortable. Always a cool customer, but they made sure they've crowded his space when he's gotten the ball. That's a big man move inside. There by number 24. Darius Webster. That's just one of them, you know, Webster. Wanted that bucket more than the defender wanted to stop him. That's just a light foul right there. Webster says it takes a lot more than that. As he gets the and one, has a chance for the 3-point play the hard way. Webster with interest from Delaware State as well as FAMU. 9-point game. De La Rosa trying to crank things up on DeShane M. Coming close to a 5-second violation. Should have been called already, but DeShane gets it out of there. Ball last touch by Evelyn Mack Academy. It'll stay with Believe Prep. They'll have 4 seconds to work with. Ball still loose, and that is how we close the first half. 41-32, Evelyn Mack leading. We'll be back after this halftime break. Second half is underway. 9-point advantage for Evelyn Mack Academy. Demari Pierce stops, pops. Can't get it to roll after a couple bounces. Deshane M will pass it ahead for Believe Prep. That's the number 11. It's Marcus B who got it right back. Looks like we'll have a foul on the floor. Good second effort. Here by number 15, that's Isaiah Brown. Brown makes it a 7-point game, 34-41. Pass ahead, they lob it up for Waylon. Waylon drops it off. Foul on the play, gonna go against Marcus B. Lead push to double digits. It's TJ Killings. Cuts it back to a single digit deficit. 8-point game. Shot off the mark. Marcus B ahead to Killings. Killings was lost initially, but gathered in time for the lay-in by number 15, that's Brown. Brown makes it a 6-point game. Second effort, nobody boxed him out. He lays it in accordingly, that's Akeem White. White with interest from Delaware State. Looking to increase it. Nice pass by Waylon. Paris left it just short. I believe Prep has numbers. It's Deshane M with the lay-in. Kwame Nelson ahead to Malik Lou Mitchell. Lou Mitchell has it poked away and a foul gonna go against Killings. He's not too happy with the call. Free throw good by Lou Mitchell. Second one good as well. So 50-42, 8-point advantage for Evelyn Mack. Jump shot knocked down there by number 21, that's Ashton Spears. So Spears makes it a 5-point game. Plenty of time left, just under 17 minutes left to play here in the second half, and it looks like it will be a very good one. As Deshane M called for a foul there. He's trying to deny Kwame Nelson. Good move and finish on the inside there by Ashton Spears. Seen him knock down a couple jumpers. He gets the lay-in inside. Now the steal. Would have been an assist. That one wouldn't stay down for James Lindsay. We're tied at 50 apiece. Baseline cut off, spinning away from it. There's Nelson. Tough shot forced there by the defense for Believe Prep. Here's a catch and shoot three there by Spears. No good. Long rebound to Lou Mitchell. Lou Mitchell in a little bit of trouble there. Had a couple defenders on him as well as the sideline serving as another one. Three-pointer off the mark. Offensive rebound in a little bit of trouble. Ashton Spears pokes it away. Evelyn Mack not giving up on the play. Get that out of here, but going to be some contact on the attempt. That's Moussa Cora, the Frenchman, stuck with the play, called for the foul, so he will send Spears to the line. Cannot get the free throws to go. Paris weaving through traffic. Takes some contact. He's going to try to sell the fact that he was shooting. He had already passed that one off, though, but can't knock him for trying. We're tied at 50 apiece, 15 minutes, 29 seconds. Remaining here on the game clock. Harris, tough shot in between two defenders. Can't get it to go. Believe Prep looking to push. Wraparound pass along the baseline. They lose the handle on it. Still lose for a second. We're going to have a double dribble against Holden Red Park. Not sure whether he double dribbled or not, but it just looked like an awkward sequence. I think we all were just expecting a turnover there in that instance. As it just seemed like Red Park was caught between a rock and a hard place, had a tough time getting rid of the ball. And finally called for the double dribble. Lou Mitchell has it poked away, but Andrew Ziegler right there with it. Ziegler has it stripped away. Ball still loose, going to the deck to get it. We're going to have a jump ball there as Quamaine Nelson and Derek Green tie each other up for it. Possession arrow is going to send it to Believe Prep. 14 minutes, 47 seconds remaining here in the second half. Tied at 50 apiece, Evelyn Mack has led for the majority of the game. Red Parth, short memory there with that last turnover. Comes back down, knocks down a triple. 53-50. So the first lead in quite a while for Believe Prep. Had a modest lead early on as both teams were getting loose. Since then, it's been Evelyn Mack ahead for the majority of it. Jamari Paris. Has done a good job on him defensively so far, but another one of those players is going to make you play the full time. Gonna have to do it for both halves. Known to make his presence felt. His most recent triple ties us up at 53 apiece. Paris with offers from Fordham, Nevada, Newberry, Quinnipiac. Just to name a few. Whalen able to use that wingspan to poke that one away. Paris trying to get back-to-back threes. No good. Ziegler going for the rebound. No, sir, says Isaiah Brown. Pass ahead to Green. Green behind the back. Step back. Nice screen. Nice splash there by number 23, Derek Green. Ziegler with the nifty moves. It's tipped, but over to Malik Lou Mitchell. He'll make the pass to Nelson. Nelson tried to will that one in. It won't go. Red Parth with the rebound. It was a lead for Belief Prep, but tying it up. Both teams with double nickels as we approach the 13-minute mark, 13:03 and counting. Red Parth for three. Good. Last one, didn't need any rim. That one touches a couple pieces of it. Still trickles down for the trifecta, 53. A 55 to 58, I should say. Lou Mitchell trying to match. Can't get it to go. Ball tipped around. Knew that was going to be a tough shot to make it up there with. It was blocked away. Almost good by a second effort for Brown. But he couldn't get it to go. But Evelyn Mack gives it right back. Brown with it in the corner, guarded by Whalen. That's just a foul if you're Whalen. You prefer to hold on to that one. It was just he and Isaiah Brown one-on-one. Whalen tried to close up the space in between he and Brown and really just made it an easy foul for Brown to be able to initiate on Whalen. You look at this game, how it's going back and forth. Could really easily end up being one of those games to where the team that has the ball last can win it. You want to be able to save those fouls for a good situation. But Whalen will have a seat for a few minutes. Couple subs in for Evelyn Mack Academy. Derek Green can't cash in on the extra opportunity, but if you're Evelyn Mack Academy, there's too many possessions or too many opportunities there on that one possession. Neither one of these squads one that you can give extra possessions to without putting yourself in a tough position. 55-58, Belief Prep, 3-point advantage. Nearly stolen there by De La Rosa. Marcus B kicks it to Red Park. Red Park back out. Here's Green. Green throws that chicken wing out there. Drives in and gets the and one. Let's take another look at that one. You can see him kind of extend that arm a little bit, get Paris out of the way. Then it's just eating the contact from there. I think it was a good move. Got the step on Paris. Paris tried to see if he could get an offensive foul call there. Savvy attempt. Anytime you see that arm extended, sometimes you can bait the official into it. That time he wasn't going, though. And that's an and one, 55-61. They had the alley, the oop, interrupted by Green. Pass inside, though. Looks like it was partially blocked, but sticking with it and scoring it. That's Akeem White. That'll make it 57-61. A power dribble. That one smacked out of there. Foul on the play. I think the officials need to get back to letting them play. And when I say I think the officials can let them play, I acknowledge my bias when it comes to that. Want to just be able to see these two teams go at it. Obviously, you want order out there, but anything outside of a foul you have to call, would like to be able to see them play through it. I think for the most part, the officials have done a good job with that. A couple ticky-tack ones here and there, but it's always easier to critique the official when you're not the one out there making the calls in game speed. So, understandable. De La Rosa gets it from point A to point B quickly, kisses that one off the window, makes it 59-62. Derrick Green with the ball, crossing the timeline, guarded by Andy Ziegler. Gets the step on Ziegler. Was going up to finish that one. Ziegler recovered. Got a hand on it. Nice recovery there by Ziegler. Does that look like it was just going to be another Derrick Green finish? Instead, on the other end, two-hand yam there by number 24. That's Webster. Lee Prep tries to answer right back. So you see De La Rosa, he had just scored one. Crosses a defender over, and it's time to help somebody else eat. De La Rosa with the assist. Webster with the slam. Evelyn Mack Academy team can be a very fun team to watch in different modes. But when De La Rosa and Paris and Lou Mitchell get rolling, and the others like Nelson, Webster, and Whalen are able to reap the benefits. Can be a fun squad to watch. You give credit to Believe Prep, because for the most part, you know, they've made sure, you know, while some of those guys have picked their spots in terms of Paris knocking down some jumpers, De La Rosa getting some transition buckets, they've made sure that they've kept them at bay for the most part here throughout this game. De La Rosa gets another bucket. I think both of these squads, when you look at the pieces that are out there on the floor, you know, there's not going to be just total shutdown across the board. You know, players like Paris, De La Rosa, they're going to pick their spots and score. Same thing with, you know, a Derrick Green who's at the free throw line right now with TJ Killings. Not going to shut all of those guys down at once. But what you don't want is all of them getting off to the races, everybody involved in scoring at the same clip. Free throw in and out. Can't take advantage of the 1-1. Haven't seen Paris handle the ball that much this game without having two blue jerseys around him at all times. Nine minutes, 31 seconds. Nelson gets it over to Whalen. Whalen faces up now. Now he'll step back. A little bit of contact there on the arm, but he can't get that foul call. Or actually, it looks like they did get it just a little late. No, that's my misunderstanding. So it was looks like it was a loose ball foul against Evelyn Mack. That's going to send Deshane M to the free throw line. With a 2-point game. Chance to push the lead to four here at the free throw line. That one's off the back of the rim. You know, obviously you get a foul notch against the other team, but when you miss the front end of a 1-1, very symbolic to a turnover. In terms of not being able to take advantage of those free points and essentially the defense getting a stop, Sons having to give up another team and personal foul. But De La Rosa called for the foul. Now, see, now, I mentioned a couple minutes ago how, you know, it's easy to criticize the officials on certain plays. I gave him the benefit of the doubt. I acknowledge my bias, but I'll say like that right there. De La Rosa is trying to tighten the screws up on DeShane M. Both of those guys have been, you know, trying to, you know, invade each other's space, make things as tough as possible. That's a foul you can avoid calling. That free throw was missed. Maybe a case of the ball not lying, but that might not be true because Evelyn Mack turned it right over as I was just saying that. 63-65. Pass ahead to Webster. Webster fouled by Green. The last 3 1-1 trips at the free throw line for Believe Prep, they missed the front end. They lead by two, but have had multiple chances to add to that lead. Doris Webster at the line with a chance to tie it up. First one's good. Substitution for Believe Prep number four has checked into the game. That's James Lindsay. DeShane M will have a seat. Webster can tie us up at 65 apiece. That one's in and out. So EMA pulls to within one. Foul called there on the screen. Being set there by Marcus B. In need of a lifeline there, trying to find one. Tried to force it to Webster. Marcus B wasn't having it. They get it still coming the other way. Lindsay hanging in the air, no foul called. Sticking with it. There is number three, Jeremy Hayes. That one looked like a tough situation for 22 feet when Akeem White got caught. Waited too late to try to get the ball to a guard, turned it over as a result. Foul going to go against Believe Prep. Both teams in the bonus, so. Who's going to be able to knock down their free throws as we come down this stretch under the 8-minute mark? One thing you can say about the officials is that they've caught it consistently on both sides. Times where they've let them play, they've let them play on both sides. There were times where they might have been a little looser with the whistle than others. That's been on both sides as well. So the paradigms may vary. You ask for consistency, we've gotten that. You ask for a good game, we've gotten that one as well. It's 67-65. Believe Prep with the 2-point advantage. Evelyn Mack has a chance to tie it up. Here at the line, that's Akeem White. Mentioned White with interest from Delaware State. 6'6", junior. Gets the bounce. splits a pair of free throws. Waylon, he's been eating glass over the past couple minutes. Can they convert? Akeem White said, yes, we can. Missed that free throw, but goes, gets that one plus another. And now it's a one-point advantage for Evelyn Mack. A turnover. We'll give it right back to the Wildcats. The speedy De La Rosa inside. 70-67. Out to Isaiah Brown. That 3-pointer is off the mark. Offensive rebound, though. Believe Prep working it around. That one won't go. Number 5, DeShane, subbing back into the game and back to his assignment of Elvis De La Rosa. He gets the back tap there, picked up by Hayes. Now here's Spears. Spears with the lay-in. Makes it a one-point game. That's what I talked about with De La Rosa and DeShane going at it. Now DeShane, he's checked in and picked up 2 steals within 20 seconds of doing so. No assist there. Isaiah Brown, Johnny, on the spot. He's done a good job of that throughout this game, just attacking the glass, getting himself in a good position to finish, and doing so when they get him the ball. But it's De La Rosa coming right back. To 71 in favor of Evelyn Mack. The past couple minutes have had a track meet feel to it. Easy layup drill for the Shane Hill. We're going to have a timeout. Have a timeout. We'll take it with them. When we get back, we'll bring you more 22 Feet Academy President's Day Showcase. Minutes 53 seconds remaining here in this one. 72-70. It's actually 73-72. It's a 1-point advantage for Believe Prep. They're the guests on the scoreboard. Some contact on that play. Officials let them play. And it's EMA sticking with it and getting the 1-point advantage. Back and forth, the pendulum swinging. Spears for 3, no good. Waylon, he's been used, rebounding the ball. Can he protect it and get it out of there? He'll be fouled. And we'll head to the free throw line. Bonus scenario, so 2 free throws for Waylon, regardless of whether the first one hits or not. First one misses. Talked about the priceless question of who's going to hit their free throws over the next few minutes. Waylon splits a pair. Makes it 75-73. We've got a timeout. We'll take one with them. When we get back, we'll bring you more here from 22 Feet Academy and the President's Day Showcase.
8 seconds. Inbound pass to Marbury. As he works on the defense of Johnson, dribbles by Robinson, takes it to the baseline, running jump shot. Good! 2 seconds left.
Seconds away from getting the action back going. 5 minutes, 28 seconds remaining here on the game clock. 2-point advantage for Evelyn Mack Academy. Believe Prep with the ball. Deshane M, guarded by Elvis. De La Rosa, a matchup to keep your eyes on. Both of those guys pick pockets on a regular basis and can really push the tempo. There's De La Rosa in the paint amongst the trees, getting the rebound and trying to get it ahead. You look right there and you say he had three blue jerseys around him. If he gets it ahead, it's a layup. He knows that. He was trying to get rid of it, but those aforementioned three blue jerseys not making it easy to. But luckily for Evelyn Mack, they retain possession. Have a chance to add to a 2-point lead. As we approach the 5-minute mark, here's Whalen. Interesting footwork on the inside. Can't get it to go. And a good job of getting positioning on the inside by Marcus B as Whalen is called for that foul. Double bonus situation with 10 team fouls apiece. So you might have to get used to that drill of a foul being called and taking the long walk to the other side of the floor for two free throws. So Marcus B at the line. First free throw's good. Seventy-five apiece. We have another tie here in this one. You could liken it to a 0-0, but there's been way too many points scored since then, so we'll just say we're tied up. Stolen, I should say, and ahead, that's Deshane M using his body against Damari Paris and getting the and one. Love to see players go up and finish with the intention of scoring, whether the foul is called or not. You see Deshane doing a good job of initiating the contact, getting the and one. That three-point play the hard way makes it 78-75. Good patience shown by Webster. Got it. Used a little subtle fake. Let the defender go right by him. Made it 78-77. 1-point advantage. Shane has to be careful. You don't want to dribble too much, regardless of the matchup, especially with the opportunistic De La Rosa guarding you. Loses the handle on that one. Evelyn Mack has it. Damari Paris with it now. Paris fouled on the play. Paris' first free throw is good. At times you see Paris take on the role of a scorer. Always plays that point guard role well, but if the situation or the angles call for him to score, he can do that. But even at times where he's not scoring as much as his average, which is right around 24 points a game, he's going to do what he needs to from the point guard's position to make sure you're in striking distance and in a spot where you can win the game. Sometimes it's just being a table setter for others, making sure they handle the pressure and get it across the timeline. Also does a good job of getting to the free throw line as he come down in the crunch time. Whalen blocks that one out of there. It's 79-78. 1 point advantage for EMA. De La Rosa loses the handle. Luckily for him, Akeem White picks it up. But then gets called for the offensive foul. Like the plays we're seeing Marcus B for Believe Prep make. Making some stuff you'll see in the box score. But also doing a good job with the intangibles as well. A lot of the blue collar plays. Not to relegate them just to the helmet and lunch pail plays, but those instances make a difference in the final score of a game as well. It is a 1 point advantage now for EMA. TJ Killings with it. So it hasn't been an easy day on the defensive end for Elvis De La Rosa. He had to guard DeShane M for most of it. Then he was on TJ Killings for a second there. But he's not complaining. Approaching the 3 minute mark. There's Green. Green has his baseline cut off. Nice defense there by Whalen as Killings will be called for the travel. Two minutes, 50 seconds and counting. Remaining here in the second half. Paris can't get that shot to go. Pass ahead to Killings. Killings with the lay-in. Talked about how explosive Killings can be in terms of those springs. Just laid that one in, but even on the lay-ins, you see the potential to be able to finish with the way he can jump. Webster trying to get it to Paris. Now Webster going to try a three-pointer. Good. There's Webster. Oh, cookies. You might have been able to hear that on the broadcast. De La Rosa, you had to give him the roll there off of that clean rip. What a sequence there by De La Rosa as he makes it 84-80. Follows up on that Webster three-pointer with a nice steal and finish. That's a big play there by Elvis De La Rosa. We'll have a timeout. We'll take one with him, but not before we look at this play. A clean rip by De La Rosa. There sets it up. Nice little spin move and the finish. Long live the king, Elvis De La Rosa, eating here in Greenville. We'll be back. Back out of the timeout, 1 minute, 13 seconds. Remaining here. In the contest, it's a 4 point advantage for Evelyn Mack. DeShane M, called for the travel. He wanted a foul call on the play. None was called and he's called for the travel. Prep enforce a turnover mode. Thought they had one there. They're called for the foul, and I believe Prep coaching staff not happy about it. He You can understand the frustration on the Believe Prep side. They felt like DeShane M was fouled on his last drive attempt. No call. He turned it over on the traveling violation. Then they think they have a steal in their hands, and instead it's going to be Damari Paris at the free throw line, and he's not a guy you want to see there if you're the opposing team. So he makes it 85-80. Now. Green, three-pointer out of the corner. Off the mark. Paris picks it up. It's going to be fouled by Ashton Spears. 48.2 seconds on the game clock. Both of these teams will be here tomorrow as well, as Evelyn Mack will play Combine out of Georgia, the Combine Black Squad at 1 p.m. tomorrow. And Believe Prep will play the 22-feet National Squad here on site. Floater off the back of the rim. Isaiah Brown with the rebound. He can't get it to go, sticks with it. Makes it 82-88, a turnover. Nelson gets back and blocks it. Tough turn of events there for Believe Prep, as they had gotten the steal. So you take a look right there, you see the Isaiah Brown tip in. So you see Nelson with the turnover. You think it's an easy layup, right? That ball was still going up. He blocks it out of there. So if you're Coach Premise, you don't want to see the turnover there, but he makes up for it by making sure they don't convert said turnover into points. 29.2 seconds remaining here in the game. But let's look at the schedule for the remainder of the day. At 1 p.m., it'll be Combine White versus the 22-feet varsity squad. 3 p.m., Combine Black versus S4G out of North Carolina. 5 p.m., 22-feet Select versus Middle Georgia Prep. And at 7 p.m., 22-feet National Squad take on Action Sports Academy out of the Atlanta area. Tomorrow at 1 p.m., I mentioned already Combine Black versus Evelyn Mack. At 2:45, you've got Action Sports Academy versus Deeper Life Academy. 4:30 p.m., you've got S4G versus Middle Georgia Prep. 6:15, 22-feet versus Believe Prep. And wrapping up at 8 p.m., Deeper Life versus Combine White. Ball's going to be stolen. So stranger things have happened. If they can get a quick one here, Believe Prep might be in business. That one's left short. Ball poked out of bounds. Surprise, Believe Prep didn't try to go for the quick three there. Brown will inbound it. Gets it to Green. Over to Spears. Evelyn Mack just trying not to foul. So you got a quick timeout taken by Believe Prep with 1 second on the clock. You saw Evelyn Prep there just trying to make sure they made Believe Prep make the shot versus getting called for a foul, sending them to the line to score with no time running off the clock. So 1 second. And this one is over. Whalen just going to toss it up. Going to be stolen, and that will do it. Appreciate you joining us here on SUV TV as we have our first final score of the day. 88-84 in favor of Believe Prep. Stick with us for more 22 Feet Academy. Sorry, in favor of Evelyn Mack Academy. Stick with us for more President's Day Showcase action here from Greenville, South Carolina.